Okay, let's hop on over to internet screen then. There we go. The Hallowed Handbook. Quick shout out to Crisenial after letting me use his original document, so copied over quite a lot from that. Helped a lot because actually handbooks take quite a bit of time. Not exactly the quickest or the easiest thing to do. I'll just run through it quickly. So I only just noticed today I had the wrong image up. I still had the Wandering Warriors and I was like, oops, this is not a $25,000 tournament, not too good. Shout out to T19 Dave for hosting the main event. All the maps, one up from Crisini, so that's great. Without the WWC going on, we wouldn't be having this tournament. So I read a comment on Facebook a few days ago in the big Age of Empires 2. I will do a squat, Julie. We're at 25k, it's not worth it. Ooh, one squat. I read a comment on Facebook that said all tournaments should have prize pools and whatnot. And it's so good to like bring together like 320 participants we got. So it's so nice to actually be able to do this. It really is. There's far more to tournaments than big money. Jibber, thanks for the prime amount. Okay, I'm not going to run through everything, but I'll go through the bits that are important. So, multiple brackets, single elimination, just like WWC. I had a sign-up clause of as you are allowed to enter if you had a smaller max rating of 1800, and then there was a tolerance of plus 1%. So that was like a sign-up of 1818, and any less than that would have been fine. Reason we do that, 1%, it's not really fair if somebody gets to like 1796 and then wants to like get over that 1800, like these 1800, 1900, like those, these are usually goals for people, right? So if somebody goes a little bit over, it's not really always their fault, but if they went over the 1818, then I said that's more than one game over the evil limit, and I was like, well, that's probably not going to be doable. And Jade, thanks for gifting as well. Shout out to GBR and Daisy Chain, who did give me some advice on certain things as well. They will be admining a little bit, but most will just be coming to me. My Discord username's there, my Steam as well, and my email account. Okay, timeline, nothing too exciting there. Did have the sign-ups open for 2 weeks. And we're doing the bracket announcement right now. One thing that did come up was the weeks. So it was kind of pointed out from WWC by King Boo, actually, because it's a Saturday to... sorry, a Friday to Friday week? I don't know what it is, but it's... I wasn't inclusive of weekends. So we done Wednesday to Wednesday, and that's kind of to help people... Well, people are going to be working, right? So this Wednesday to Wednesday week should give you the full weekend to get something in a couple of days after and a couple of days before the weekend. So it should make things a bit easier. We'd be expecting you guys to play one set a week and then try not to go ahead of the schedule because we're going to be implementing the Civ ban system, just like from WWC, of the most played Civs every round. So try not to go ahead of the schedule unless you've had... approval from an admin. Everybody should be in the Discord. Most likely we'll be here. This is a big one. By registering for the tournament, participants accept all rules and settings stated in this document. How many people have actually read the handbook? Had a good look. Hands up. Who's not read it? There's got to be a few people. Okay, we're doing alright. That's a lot of ones. There's a lot that, it's either the people that have read it are very proud of it, and then the people that haven't read it are obviously not a bit into it. All good. Okay, the chat's going way too fast. Any changes made to the registration? Yep. Smurfing. I think the one thing I was saying smurfing was I did take out a few accounts. Nothing that was too bad, but people probably just chancing their arm. Typically someone with too high win percentage. I did have to move someone up in a lower bracket as well to a higher bracket just because their win percentage was too high. But nothing too bad. I was quite pleased checking through all the accounts in the last couple of days. Nothing too terrible. I was quite pleased that anybody that did have an alt account did provide their info, except from a couple. Somebody didn't disclose they had an alt account called Controller Player. No names. Was meant to be disclosed. I let it pass because it's all out there in the public anyway. Another small part, just try and make sure you have someone that can translate, or, you know, if you need some info translated, obviously the document's only in English. Just try and ask for that as I say this in English. Doesn't really make a lot of sense, to be honest. I'm just realizing it as I say it. It'd be ideal, I think, if tournaments had, like, handbooks in multiple languages, but that's obviously difficult, right? Having, like, something translated. I think Spanish, Chinese, and I think that'd be the two main ones, right? If they could get, like, a translation for Spanish and Chinese, would be good. Alrighty, so what I mentioned, similar to Wandering Warriors Cup, a global ban will be applied to all brackets, with the most played Civ from the previous round being banned from use for future rounds. The Civ drafts will be edited and updated when needed. Please do not schedule a set ahead of time. Scheduling is Wednesday to Wednesday format. Civ draft links will be updated Tuesday evening prior to the new game week. So what we decided earlier was the most played from all the brackets put together will be global banned for the rest of the tournament. And then I'll have to edit these presets as we go along, and then I'll just take out the civs, and then I'll re-update the links. Who wants to draft? First in here. Abdallah Ibn Yasin. I don't know if that's any good. Clifford on the ball, my man. So drafting is a relatively simple process. I think one thing I will say is the drafts throughout it are very different. So try and familiarize yourself with each and every one, because it's likely going to test you if you do get further on. As you do get further on, there's going to be like two bans and a snipe in the round of 8 and the round of 4, whereas round of 32 and round of 16 will be really different, where you can just pick whatever civs you want and it will be able to play. I think for earlier rounds, like best of 3s can be pretty brutal, right? Like if you lose one game, or if you lose game 1, it can be really difficult to come back. And it can be hard, so it's nice to have all civs playable. So if you want to prepare for something, you can do it. Bob Ross, why is random an option? It's a good question, right? Actually, I think once your timer goes out, it just automatically goes to random. So I think it has to have an option there. How it works is you just click ready up. You want to get 30 seconds to actually pick a civ, so try and have something in mind. What I would say is let your timer go all the way down, because if you pick one right now, you've lost that time, right? So you want to try and think ahead. I've just picked Burgundians for the sake of it. And the way it works, higher seed goes first, so they will have to host. Clifford was a lower seed, so he's just going to pick two civs after. He goes for the first, and then I'll get two. Okay, so I'll just let the time run down. and then I'm wanting to start thinking about what he has already. So Berbers, probably going to be a difficult one to deal with. Britons, you want to start thinking about potential counterplays for those ones, and you have to think about maps as well. Your home map and your away map. Should be pretty simple, right? Let's get Bulgarians. Glad there's no set ban in early round. Yeah, I think it makes sense for best of three, but once you get further on, I think it's good to have different settings. And that tests the players in different ways. I don't like having very similar drafts all the way through. And we can take a look at that one. And I'll finish on Bohemians, because they're Pog. And when you're done, you'll just copy and paste that link, and you're posting Rex. That'll get posted in there as well. Let's have a look at the best of five. You can see it's a lot different. A lot different. Map drafting will be done on disc, yes. It'll be done on DMs. Inner DMs. Let's go again. Who's gonna get this one? Belgium. Are we starting with Malians and Spanish available? Yep. Every sip's playable from the beginning. You can see really different here. We get two bans each, and then we're going to finish on a snipe as well. So you can actually see what's going to happen on the draft if you just got the top. And I just want to get rid of... Well, typically you want to go for sieves. There's two approaches. You can go for sieves that you don't want to play against, or you can actually just get rid of weaker sieves because you want to keep the stronger sieves playable. So that's the two main approaches you could go. So, like, Belgium's going to get rid of Spanish. I'm going to get rid of Turks. So two sieves, it can be awkward, right? Whereas I'm not really interested in getting rid of good sieves because I want to be able to pick them. So I'll just pick Bulgarians. And then that way, I guarantee you having a good sieve, at least. And I should be able to get another high one. So it's two different things you can consider. If you're doing a snipe in best of five, shouldn't you pick seven to have one extra? Nope. Not in this one. Not in this one, my man. Okay, so I want to go Mongols now. Just go Bohemians. Let's just get through this one. Berbers. Huns, and decide on a snipe. You have to go down to the bottom for it, of course. And it'll be revealed when Flemel does his. Whoa, already had that one. And that one. Okay, so the caveat here is, it's a best of five, right? So you want to get five sieves available. So once you get towards the end of the set, it might become more apparent when and where sieves are going to get played. When those sieves will get played. So, you know, it's different kind of drafting for different rounds. You should be able to adapt as players. And it's not always good to have... it's not always good to have spare sieves. Not always. And there will be chances for that. So how do you match with your opponent? I've never used this thingy. The links are in here, and they're all hyperlinked, and then you just go on it. And you say create new draft on this preset, higher seed hosts, you're gonna get sent it. If you're a lower seed, then you're gonna click guest. Nice and easy. Nice and easy. I'm guessing that makes sense for everybody, yes. What if you run out of time and you get a DSF you can't play? Good question. Yeah, bad luck, I suppose. Don't run out of time. And if you get randomed that, then that's pretty bad. You won't be able to use it. The very worst you don't have it, your sieve will be able to get picked by the opponent. Yep. If you do not have it and you don't want to buy it. The opponent buys your DLC. That would be good. Yeah, the solution to that would be your opponent gets to pick your sieve. I should really be taking notes. Just in case. Somebody's dumb enough to do that. Just in case, guys. Yeah. Pretty simple stuff though. Given patch, make sure that's always up to date. Cheating or hacking, if you feel like anybody's doing something dodgy, make sure you send us a rex. Try and keep it in DMs as well. Don't publicly accuse anybody. And if you are gonna DM me with some accusations, you better be good. And you better have some evidence and not just be salt. Please just don't message me with salty messages that you got beat. Please be respectful of each other, make sure we cooperate. I think that's important. Make sure you try and work with each other, don't beat each other's neck. If somebody needs to go for a bathroom break or whatnot, don't be somebody that overly pauses in game. Or yeah, I mean, most people should know how to act. It might be the first tournaments for some people, but it's no money involved. It's a World Evil tournament. The only thing at stake here is pride. Is there a prize for this tournament? Yes, pride. Pride is at stake here, Tim. The only thing that's important. Messaging if someone doesn't good luck Cadfin at the start. It's hard to say sometimes because a lot of time it happens in the lobby, right? Twice the pride, double the fall. Could see that. people are allowed to use any graphical or UI mods publicly available at an official mod workshop. Not that I'm very keen on them, especially the Town Centre one and the Manganel one, but it's one of these things, like, you can't, there's no point implementing rules that you can't prove for everybody, so it's one of these things you kind of have to have. No streaming while playing, did I read that somewhere? Probably in the other handbook, Boxer. The music is kind of distracting. Let's turn it down a little bit then. That's pretty quiet. That should be fine, right? If Dave doesn't go for demos every game, I'm going to be fuming. I think it's a fair comment. TC1 is in game. Hard to say it wouldn't be allowed. Yeah, I'm not. This is my personal preference, is what I'm saying, Teapot. I don't agree with it. It's something that's been implemented as an official mod, but used to be an unofficial mod beforehand. It's only been implemented in the game in recent months. Like the towers and the, like, nah, it's, I think it's like so far to what competitive Age of Empires should be, but then where do you draw the line in some things like red mod and everything? Which obviously helps a lot, especially when you have maps with a lot of hills. I don't know anybody that makes maps with a lot of hills and makes it really hard to wall sometimes. The good job is there's not a lot of that on Nomad. Okay, all players are seeded based on a combination of their highest achieve and current. That was a 50-50 split. Ratings are fetched from the rank leaderboards. Account to register us, seeming plot going after. Yeah, kill. Cool. something on scheduling. If players are unable to play at scheduled time, attempts may be made to accommodate the player's situation. Still, no guarantee of insurance. Failing to play at scheduled time may lead to DQ. What I will say is you have 30 minutes to... Is there a prize for the winners? No, there is no prizes. No money, no money on the line here. It's... Oh my god. To me, it's inappropriate to have cash prizes for WoW tournaments. Because then you're just opening yourself up to smurfs all over the place. So try and mitigate that risk as much as you can. And if they don't have any money to go for, it does help. Oh, the player fails to show up every 20 minutes, or maybe that's what I copied over. If you don't show up within 20 minutes of your scheduled time, you will be granted an administrative game win thereupon. So if it's a best of three, after 30 minutes you'll be gone, you'll be up 2-0. So it's... And you get a win of a game every 20 minutes and every 10 minutes afterwards. And if it's like a best of five and he turns up after half an hour, he's 2-0 up. I got called a smurf in Empire's Wars, but one are they? Should I declare that? No. We could do funny community-based non-cash prizes, like a cool drawing or something. I don't know if you've seen how I draw. But yeah, if people were interested in doing that, that did happen for the last tournament I organised. Brockdove. It was a Nomad tournament, right? So he sent of the wool brackets a Lego, or was it Lego? It was either, I think it was Playmobil actually, like a camping set of like people camping, because it was Nomad, of course. I can't remember if it was Lego or Playmobil, but he sent like six of them away, and they were like $20 a pop. If you require special dispensation to cover the weekly schedule, then you must contact an admin, so please do that. Wholesome as fuck, yeah. I think it was Lego, right? Please post your schedule time in a Discord, use a Discord name, example. So you want to put your Discord username, guys, so people can see. Obviously, when it's in Discord, try and keep it to Discord when you're doing comms. But when you're posting Rex, use the in-game player name. Brackets open, yep. Okay, recorded games. All games during the event must be recorded. Time frame, yep. Listen, looks all good to me. Semi-finals and finals recorded games will be sent to the tournament admin directly. And don't tell me the score when you do it. I don't need to know the score, so just send me the Rex. Then I'll cast the game. Try and the side is going to send the Rex before it as well. No, he was banned. He was banned. Ricardo was banned. I can see him. I'm in mod view right now. During civilization drafts, players must not draft civs if they don't have access to the game. Yeah, there we go. If a player plays with restricted civ, then the game must be restarted. So even if we don't get it, the player will get to pick something that you... I think it doesn't even get to the game point. They can do that. I will say one thing. It's up to you guys what you want to do, right? Like, if someone accidentally leaves on random... I've done it before. You can sort it out. Is there any real one creates games, host games? Depends on... The host should be the higher seed, right? But if you have bad pings, it might be something you have to flip-flop. Like, let's just say for me, UK, going to like, let's say Pacific time in the US, the West Coast, it might be a difficult one, or that might just be like East Coast US. That's not a good example. How about East Coast? So somebody lived in New York. And then if I lived in the UK, which I do, I don't know why I said if. then it'd be hard for there, because we've just got ocean between us. It's not like there's a landmass where there's servers. So you'd probably take turns. Crashes. So recommended players run a voice chat together with players reporting the issues they may experience during the game immediately increases the viability of saved games. Yeah, if you have any issues, try and get in a voice chat together. Anywhere, it doesn't really matter. Don't think that's a good idea. Verbal aggression could occur. What do you mean? Bob Ross, big boss. Just your ping list? Yeah. That's the best thing to do. Just take a picture of it. Print screen it. Mild aggression, like I will take your castle or coming for you. Bad? Yeah. Voice chat for resolving issues, not during the game. Exactly, Teapot. That's what I said. Right? Although I did recently play a tournament and the guy asked me to be in voice chat. And I said yes, because he was uploading it to YouTube. It didn't really bother me. Have you rigged me to play Jibber yet? Soon find out. JBR was maybe a little bit lucky to make it in our bracket. In each series, players will be granted one restart. Restarts must be called no later than 4 in-game minutes. So please don't send me a rec where you call a re in 401. Because by rules, I can't allow that. It's up to the players if they want to continue that and go for a re, but if someone's going to make a fuss, then it's up to them to make a fuss. I really can't stop that from happening because the rules are the rules. After restart, sieves and colors must remain the same. So you would really use a restart when you have something like a bad map. Let's say you didn't get your TC down to like, or it's not your TC's not up to like 4 minutes, or you really don't like your if you don't like your position, then that'd be an instance where you use your restart. Rerex must also be sent? No, that's one thing you wouldn't need to send me is a rerex. You just send me the one from the real game. Rerex really never gets sent. Players can request a restart in situations where the maps are bugged, or otherwise fail to generate in the intended way. This is going to be pretty rare, guys, because these maps are pog. Something that maybe happen is, I don't know, like a boar getting bugged inside of berries, but I've not seen really any bugged maps. And see, to be honest, when it comes to Nomad start maps, res doesn't really belong to anybody. My res is your res and your res is my res. Obviously I'm not going to be contactable at every moment of the day, so if you do have an issue, either DM me or put it in the questions and discussion thread. And maybe somebody can help get you to it. I had a bug where I could build a stable arrange. That seems like an in-game bug, not so much a map bug, you know what I mean? Are you the only admin Twixer? Technically yes. But we do have JBR and Daisy Chain. We'll be hanging about if they need help. When brackets? Soon. If I lose, it's due to a bugged map. A bugged nap. Gotta hate those bug naps. Pausing. Players must only pause the game if their opponents are experiencing severe issues that are directly affecting the gameplay and their ability to play. So recently my game's been... I've been getting disconnected from the server quite a bit recently when I've been playing. you know, we have that moment where everything freezes, but you know the game's still going on. The best thing to do is probably pause and just let your opponent know, which can be super tilting, especially when you're about to like engage up with an army, because you can't control it. And then the game has to catch up, so it speeds through it, and you can't do anything in those instances. Like, it's not good. One squat. People using their points, good. One squat. Oh god. What happens when the game crashes completely? Then you have to do the save and restore. You have 14,000 points? Fuck. The good thing is, you're a mod JB, so you have to keep count. You have to keep count of all these. Or I'll go back and have to do it all in the VOD. Once game is paused, players must immediately inform an administrator of the situation and issues they face. That's only if things are so bad. The game might not be able to go on. You might have to think about save and restore, but just if you do not know what to do, then contact me. The player pausing the game must also be the one to pause the game. That's important. Before and pausing, the participant pausing the game must ensure the opponent's ready to continue. So, like, sorry, go, whatever you want to do. And mod power to refund them, yeah. Okay, Nomad rules. We have the tournament rules, and you're going to have the specific rules strictly to this tournament. Applies on maps with Nomad start and only pertain to the first 3 minutes of in-game time. Potentially breaking of any of the rules is strictly forbidden. So if you're not familiar, these rules are pretty standard for Nomad tournaments. Attacking enemy units, so you can't attack anybody. Can't attack the buildings, or you can't attack the hair of the boat either. I understand there might be instances where there might be a misclick or whatnot, but it's most likely going to be a zero tolerance in this one, guys. You can steal hair of the boats. You can steal them. So that's your sheep, cows, buffaloes, whatnot. Walling in enemy units and buildings is not allowed in the first 3 minutes. If you can't attack someone, you shouldn't be allowed to wall them in, right? So if somebody can't defend themselves, there's no reason why you should be allowed to wall something in. Players may not construct their first insert within range of the enemy. Laming wild animals are not allowed. It's only considered laming when... Oh, this is a big one. So it's only considered laming when not utilizing the resources. Okay, so if a player takes 35 food from one item, that is considered okay. So, let me clarify. If you take a boar within less than 3 minutes, you have to have that villager at least collect the 35 food from it. If that makes sense, it should. And it must be done before 3 minutes. What about sharing berries? Yeah, my berries are your berries. With deer as well? Yes, one item. One item, that is considered okay. So if it was a sheep, you're going to have to do it. You're going to have to not be able to do it with a sheep because you'd have to go back and forward, but your TC is probably not going to be up. Are you allowed to gate a boar attempt? For me, that's coming under... That's coming under the animals for me. Can Celts slam sheep as they never are the enemies? You can steal herdables. You can steal herdables, Jorge. I think the one thing is just don't be an ass in the first 3 minutes. By the time your TC's up, it's nearly about 3 minutes, and then if you want to be a dick, you can go be a dick. I think that's fair, right? Nomad games are usually messy, but my suggestion would be just don't put yourself in a sticky spot. And just wait to that 3 minute. If two players unintentionally build the TCs in range of each other, the game must be immediately restarted. That's going to be pretty standard, so a bit of a caveat there. If I see somebody deliberately construct a TC after knowing there's somebody like the opponent's TC is there, that'll be a loss in that game for that one. Messier the better too? Yes. Lobby settings should be pretty standard on this one. Of course, they should be public, not private like the WWC. Is this even possible with the TC zones? We don't have TC zones in the WWC maps, sorry. Don't have the boxes. We don't have the treaty. No treaty. Don't need the treaty when we've got rails. The treaty and the box is only for the degens on the ranked ladder who need it. Spec delay must be 2 minutes. Make sure you enable hidden sieves. And then everything's pretty standard. You know, conquest is a big one to remember. And AI difficulty standard, or yeah, make sure it's standard. And for some reason, extreme is now the what it's always in. What if opponent TC's within your range, but not within your Vel's LOS? Then that would be fine. That would cut. That's to me, Baron, and that's accidental, and that would be obvious. So that would be a restart. But if you see the TC. So specking is allowed, where I saw it wasn't. Yeah, I think you read the wrong... either the wrong edition. A lot of this was put together at the last second, Neil. And took over from the Wandering Warriors, so I had to edit quite a bit of it. That's an admin re? Yeah, it's an admin re, correct. This bit's gonna be the AI difficulty affects vision of animals. Exactly. This bit's gonna be important. Make sure everybody does read this. The recorded game section will be getting used by a bot. So it's really important you follow the process properly. Make sure you use the in-game name for the score, so don't use a Discord name. The spoiler tag, this one here, that letter, or the one that's in the bottom, it's not even a letter, it's just a symbol. It's a parsing symbol that's used by the bot, so if you have it in your in-game name, that's fine, but don't use it when you're posting results. So a lot of people use that for like their clan. They'll put like, let's just say the FC clan, they'll put FC, then I'll use that as a little barrier between that and your name. Just try and take that out whenever you're posting results. Make sure you label the games, G1, whatever it is, lowercase, uppercase, don't give a shit. As long as you've got the title in there, and it should have the names as well. G1, G2, G3, G4. Reporting must be completed in one message as well, so don't click enter after one, make sure it's all the one message. Any rec message as a thumbs up from the bot should be included in the daily summary, so the ones that don't pass the parsing should be easily identified. The one thing I meant to add there is try and upload dummy recs as well. Dummy recs. So if it's a best of, what it says, a best of five, or even a best of three works as well, right? Always upload the amount of recs that you have for that round. So round of three, 32 is a best of three. Always upload three. Where can we find the recs? If you go to your search bar just now, type in save game, all one word. It's lowercase, and that's where all your recs are saved. Save game. Give it a try just now. Matsuki. Real simple. Name, spoiler tag, and this will turn up black. Score for the left hand side, score for the other player on the right hand side. Round 32, it's got to say round. And it's going to say the number, I would say quarterfinals or semifinals or finals. Civ draft, you've got to make sure you use a colon as well. And then that'd be home map. Yeah, Matt's Gate. It's called, just go in your search bar and type in save game. All one word. Stealth says you will get a DM from the bot if your submission does not pass. That message will tell you what's wrong. Nice. Thank you, Stealth. And make sure you get a clap clap and chat for Stealth, who set all this up. I am ever so grateful. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Maps, of course, created and maintained by Cruzini. The map mod is in the game, with up the top hand corner with a little gear. Just trying to keep an eye on chat at the same time. So you put the score there before you didn't want to know the score for casting? Yeah, that's why it's spoiled. That's what that means. The two little symbols there, and then it blacks it out. Maps, Nomad, that's it, game one, always. Inundation, Mire, Boundary Brawl, Grapple, Compass, Golden Hill, and Houseboat. So we have, it's eight in total, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, yes. 8 in total, nearly there, guys. Broadcasting. The event offers entirely open streaming under the condition that the broadcast requirements board wholly accepted and followed. It is vital you as a content creator understand the rules and the settings of the event and encourage everyone to read for the rules and the settings even when not participating. I actually said that all right. Nice. That's quite odd for me. All streamers must display one of the provided banners before, after, and between tournament games. The tournament logo or banner must be visible at all times while in game. The broadcasters must add the custom chat command qualifying the host event, that's T90 and Dave. And players are allowed to stream their points of view. You're allowed to do it, but you do it at your own risk. Because it's extremely hard to prove if somebody's stream sniping. So you're going to have very good evidence. And one of the things you can do if you're streaming is go into mod view, and then you can see all the usernames in chat. That is one thing you can do. And then the all the images are here. I'm going to post it in chat just now for anybody that does want to stream. And it's all available in there. You just download it, and then you just add it to your scenes and whatnot. Casters! We are happy to have secured casters for each set in every bracket. I think it was important to at least guarantee T19 days for the host. I mean, technically they are, yeah. I mean, I'm the admin of the tournament, but the tournament would not be happening if it wasn't for them. So we did try and get a caster for every semi-final and final at the least. It's going to be up to them if they want to do any more games. But some of them will do more, some of them won't do any more. Brackets already announced? Nope. I've just been going through the handbook. So for bracket A, we will have Nova doing that one, so it's the top bracket. Nova's agreed to do the A's, which is really good. That's not going to work, Jojo. I'm going to do the B bracket, the J bracket, and the LEL bracket. All the logos, well, the logos for some are here, and also the hyperlinks for the... I know the hyperlinks for the Twitch profiles are there. C's, we're going to have Colin. He's on Pacific time, so that'll be different. He's going to be doing the C's. Little Trouble is going to be doing the D bracket. Magnolia on the E's. Ocean and Abyss on the F's. Bangamel on the G's. Akalno on H. And Berry on the I bracket. How many L's does he have in his name? I think he told me once before, that's why I've got the hyperlink there. So yeah, pretty pleased with that. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4 females, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 males. So we know we've got a 50-50 split. So I'm quite happy with that. lots of different time zones. Hopefully we get good coverage of it all. And really happy to have everybody on board with that one. I am really happy with that. Thank you, so T9 and Dave, for championing Nomad Base Tournament. Like, 25k, I was so pumped when I seen it, that was coming out. Krasini for doing all the maps and admin work. Let me do it. Stealth, thanks a lot for helping with the coding and everything so far. Really appreciate that one. Dead Meat and Black Ops, who did help with that process as well. And Daisy and JBR for all your helpful advice. And then we just have the change log at the end, guys, which kind of highlights other things that have been updated in the last couple of weeks. Okay, what I think I'm going to do